Being a part of travel industry, Medical Value Travel was one of the biggest hit due to COVID pandemic. This documentary, Medical Tourism on Ventilator, is an effort to share the pain and agony of the whole industry, be it hospital or a retail outlet associated with it. We being a part of it, tried to talk to some big players of the industry in Bengaluru. We covered 10 major hospitals and other associated partners of medical tourism. These visuals are of the Bangalore airport, which is deserted due to pandemic, which otherwise used to be jam-packed with medical value travelers. Let's hear from the doctors themselves.
The health industry has been no exception to the pandemic. Yes, we have been affected. And as a cardiac surgeon, the effect is quite profound. So much so, let's say, the month of January and February 2020, before the pandemic hit us, our contribution from the international market was almost 50%. Of course, this has changed now, and I don't think it's just the lack of flights, but it's also a significant contribution from the hesitation on the patient's part to come into a country like India. Are they going to be safe? Are they going to be fine? It's not surprising that the most common surgeries that people from across the world come into us is our USP, and this has been minimal access surgeries, whether it's a multi-vessel beating heart bypass or valve replacement, endoscopic repairs. All of them are what patients seek. These are not available in their country, or even if it is, they're very expensive and have a very long wait period. That's where the Indian healthcare industry kicks in.
Medical tourism is a growing sector in India. In mid-2020, India's medical tourism sector was estimated to be worth $5 to $6 billion. In 2017, 495,056 patients visited India to seek medical care. According to a report from 2019 by the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry and Ernest & Young, most of the medical tourist arrivals in India were from Southeast Asia, Middle East, Africa, and SAARC region. India also receives a significant number of medical tourists from Australia, Canada, China, Russia, the United Kingdom, and the United States.
The COVID pandemic and medical tourism into India. There are a few points that all the non-Indian outside India should know. A, the media, especially the Western media, has been very wild. They have given a wrong picturization of what is happening here. You must understand that in America, New York, still dead bodies are waiting. And America, when the numbers went high, situation went worse than India, those people started, you know, ringing the bell, clapping for doctors, etc. And they made a very sophisticated thing out of it. When we did that, people have been criticizing. But remember, our numbers, our incidence has been smaller. We have been painted with a black brush by media outside. Don't believe what you heard. Things are now normal.
We used to travel extensively to Iraq, Iran, Yemen, African countries, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh. So there were many countries that we traveled, and we had seen a variety number of patients. And we were able to help a lot of them with high-end medical care. And that was a very satisfying thing. But then the pandemic came and there was a big fall because, as you all know, the airports were restricted, the flights were restricted. So we had a significant dip. In fact, last 1.5 years, I think I can take a handful of patients that we were operating. And that too because countries took initiatives and sent plane full loads of patients and then.
Since the first wave last March, there has been a decline in the patients coming. We used to get patients from the Middle East, Iraq, Oman, and all those Yemen, and a lot of African countries we used to get, and we used to get some of the European tourists also coming for surgical.
Yes, of course, COVID has affected us. In the whole of medical practice, including medical tourism. We used to operate on 8 to 10 patients of spine surgeries every month in Manipal Hospital.
But the future remains uncertain, especially as the trajectory of the coronavirus pandemic remains unclear.
COVID pandemic has badly affected the medical healthcare system. Initially, the turnover time was very less. So whenever any outstation patient used to call us for any video consultation, we used to give them the advice, and they were able to come to us as early as possible. But now, due to the travel guidelines and other bans and other restrictions, the turnout time has become long, and that has badly affected the patients in terms of their early treatment, and the treatment is delayed rather, and it has led to more complication and increase in the cost of the treatment. So I think if as early as possible we will be able to come out of this, it will going to affect both patient healthcare as well as decrease treatment cost.
We used to get at least 8 to 10 patients from all over Gulf as well as African countries, and now it has reduced to almost 1 or 2 in a month. And more often we are seeing that the patients who are elective are coming with emergencies because they have delayed their travel to India to an extent that they have been either paralyzed or quadriplegic, and it's a bad scene actually for the patients.
Several of my patients, I should say, they deteriorated and worsened waiting for the pandemic to get over.
There were a couple of patients which came to us, but apart from that, there was no increase in the number of international patients. And I'm just waiting for the pandemic to get over, to get back to this place, to the situation where we need to do at least 50% of our work should be international. Now, what initiatives can facilitate these patients from coming in? I think one of the most important steps that government of India can do is, we all know that Indian medical system is very good and internationally known. We need to make use of it and give enough help to other countries who do not have this facility freely available. And even if some countries do, it's very exorbitant because there are very few centers which really do high-end work. For example, here in India, in our hospital, we have everything that we would require for doing, for example, a neurosurgical case. Anywhere in the US, UK, Europe, we are equal to all of them where equipment and expertise are concerned. So what the government can do, I think one is, if they can make for the next 2 years or 3 years, let them make the medical visa free so that patients are able to come. Facilitate flights which can bring in patients and for a nominal rate, and we can do expert work in that. Maybe even organize a meeting with all the private hospitals, the government, they should sit and make a uniform cost plan such that the hospital doesn't suffer, nor does the government suffer, and the patient will benefit. So we don't want one hospital to charge very exorbitant and one hospital to charge very little. So if there is a uniformity and there is the center controlling it, the hospitals would gain because it will be much more than what they would expect from a local patient. And they are able to give their expertise and help the whole world. Because as we all see, patient, whether they're from Iraq, whether they're from Yemen, whether they're from Pakistan, whether they're from England, US, UK, it's all the same. The blood is red. We have no difference and the disease per se is also so similar, and the way of treatment is very similar. So I don't think we differentiate places from our own country. And this is most important thing for a doctor. For a doctor, a patient is a patient, irrespective of where he comes. So we are eagerly waiting for an initiative from the government side. Governments of the respective countries, for example, in Turkey, Iraq, all of them can have their own plans also and link with the Indian plans so that the red tapism is cut and the patient, when required medical care, can get it as soon as possible so that, you know, the delay is not. I've had a tumor patient coming in after 6 months of trying to get a visa, and in the interim they have lost vision, which could have prevented if the visa was done in 2 to 3 days. So that is the problems that we sometimes face. I have gone to Iraq, I've seen a patient, but then the patient coming takes about 2 to 3 months because of a lot of issues that they have. So if we can iron out these issues, I think that would be a fantastic thing for medical tourism. And India has to be there upfront with all the technology and all the skills available. We need to be there upfront. Thank you.
We usually practice dental implant in our centers, but this pandemic has put a halt on global footfall of the patients.
In fact, myself, I had been to Africa and I had been to Zambia, and I could see that a lot of patients are waiting there for the transplant. During this period in COVID time also, we treated a lot of transplant cases from Africa. They came, we followed the protocols, policies, everything. But I know that there's a huge, we are not really doing testes. It must be 2-3 patients where we are able to help them out. But there is a good number of patients waiting for us for the treatment here, and we are not able to help them. So the only way what I look at is the government, if they can help us out, because of course medical tourism is also generating revenue, contributing to the foreign currency and everything. So if they will look at that point, and if they consider a lot of delays at the airport and a lot of policies in place, so I think we can still start. Like for instance, if the embassies abroad, I'm talking about the Indian embassies abroad, start promoting medical tourism and start helping us with the proper protocols and policies in place by doing the RT-PCR test, and then making them feel secure, and then whatever the airline policies, I don't think it will be a problem. Pandemic is for the worldwide, it's not for the one segment or one particular industry. So, but anyway, Bangalore does not have too much of a source of income and the channels, and medical tourism was one. Pre-pandemic, it was really booming well. And if government can interfere, involve and help us out and find some policies and protocols for us, and I'm sure the huge waiting list who are waiting across the border will have some entry, and they will be getting a lot of help.
And in major players of hospitals where these kind of patients from international countries who used to come and visit us for medical treatment which were not available, or maybe for better clinical expertise, or maybe of cost concern.
Bangalore is one of the biggest destination hubs for medical tourism, mainly because of big reputed hospitals in the city, and also the environment. It's a garden city. People like to come and stay in a comfortable environment, and also the facilities for the patients is very good. The hotel industry is good, and of course the medical industry. The hospitals are A1, world-class hospitals we have here. So of course the pandemic has caused a downward trend in the numbers of patients coming down here, but Bangalore is figures among the top medical destinations in India.
In telling about the Indian doctors are the best across the world. Even in US, data says that the patients who got treatment with the Indian doctors makes a difference.
Pandemic has disrupted international medical travel to India, and I hope we are able to emerge out of it very soon. From a business perspective, it's dealt a blow to many hospitals and disrupted the whole ecosystem, and I hope the COVID pandemic subsides very soon so that the travel resumes. Secondly, from a Bangalore perspective, I feel we are well positioned to cater to a large number of travelers from across the globe, primarily because we are well positioned in terms of medical care. We have great many number of hospitals, well-reputed hospitals who provide that kind of care, and also advanced medical technology and wonderful weather. All we need is for the pandemic to subside and for connectivity between Bangalore and other global cities to increase, so that we are able to address that demand and that potential that Bangalore is capable of addressing.
India is the destination for the medical value travel.
I have been doing heart surgeries for patients across the world since last 22 years. And patients have been coming from all over the world, not only just Asia or South Asia or Southeast Asia, but also from the Western Hemisphere. I have operated patients from United States, UK, Germany, and many other countries, especially from USA, from Chicago, from Maine, from Alabama, from various places because of their insurance issues. We have been operating complex cardiac cases. Like for example, I operated an 83 years old man from Chicago in whom I had done a mitral valve repair with bypass surgery and a maze surgery. I had done a boat contractor from Florida and I had done a mitral valve repair with bypass surgery. So we have been doing patients from across the globe, but the maximum number of patients are from Asia and Africa. Asia, a large number of patients come from the poorer part of the Gulf, the South Asia, Bangladesh, Pakistan, and Sri Lanka, Nepal. And also we get a lot of patients from Uganda, Zambia, and Nigeria, and many other countries except South Africa, almost all over Africa, Ghana, Congo, Republic of Congo, from everywhere we are getting patients, Rwanda. So patients come from all over. Probably the reason is the cost, language, warmth of the people here, and the quality of medicine that is available here.
We get patients from across the world, but mostly we get patients from Maldives. Maldives is like in the top three countries. We also get patients from Yemen, Nigeria, Sudan, Tanzania. We get a lot of queries for IVF from Ethiopia. We get a lot of patients for kidney transplant from Nigeria. And from Maldives, we get all type of patients, but mostly patients come for problem with ENT because it is situated near the ocean. And lot of queries for orthopedics from Tanzania as well. But these are the main, like from Africa, we get more patients from East Africa, from Gulf, we get more patients from Oman, Middle East, we get more patients from Yemen and few patients from Iraq. And then from SAR countries, we get patients from Maldives and Afghanistan.
Just to take you a snapshot of the medical tourism in the country, I'm talking about pre-pandemic. So the pre-pandemic, we have been treating ailing souls right from Africa, Middle East, and Asia. We have been going around in these countries in terms of treating ailing souls. Post-pandemic situation has come down in terms of people traveling for their medical treatments to our country. So this has drastically affected in the entire industry today.
The coronavirus pandemic hit the brakes on the industry's expansion with a record decline in airline demand, closure and shutdown of medical tourism agencies, and widespread financial hardships that have wrecked many industry key players. Medical tourism came to a screeching halt.
And from last 2 years, slowly, as this with this pandemic, we saw the receding number of patients coming to not only our hospital, to many other hospitals. And
not only international medical tourism, domestic medical tourism was also on a low tone because most of the focus was going towards treating COVID patients.
As a country like Thailand, Turkeys and all, so they're doing a lot of activity in an international market to showcase their healthcare system. Here is, we have our bodies like SEPZ and FICCI and all, we do a lot of events, but we are not capturing the actual buyers from the international market.
Of medical travel, the travel abroad is, first is high savings, second is no waiting list, high quality treatment, world-class facilities, access to the latest technology, you have the best surgeons, the well customer care support, travel opportunities. In fact, in 2017, with the estimated figure, there were almost 5 lakh who have visited India to seek medical treatments.
We used to get a lot of patients from Middle East, SAARC countries and Africa. Of late, in the past 1 year, we have not seen many patients. The business is not even 1/10 of what it was. Of course, pandemic has affected us and most of the hospitals and even travel industry. Indian doctors are very famous all across the world, and patients have a lot of trust and faith, especially in especially for South India. And Bangalore is an upcoming medical tourism destination. Past 5 years, the industry has grown a lot, but in 1 year we have seen a huge drop down. Although the patients want to come, but there are no flights. Even if there are flights, they're once a week, once a month, and the restrictions and protocols are very difficult. So the patients are ready to travel, but they don't have the ways how to travel. And so we're seeing a lot of, it has really affected the hospital in terms of number of patients.
Because of this COVID, the male factors have increased. It has impacted the semen parameters. It has reduced the count and motility to some extent. And many articles are coming that the COVID infected people are having a reduced chances of pregnancy.
Unfortunately, this pandemic, of course, the entire world is suffering, and there's a very bad impact. But medical value travelers, in terms of those chronic patients who have taken treatment last year, I mean before pre-pandemic, and who were supposed to come for the follow-up, there's a huge delay. There is not much support from the government I see here, because Delhi, Mumbai has direct flights, and some of the flights are still operating between Delhi and Delhi and Mumbai. And we had a lot of challenges when our own patients who wanted to come for a second round of treatment, you know, that is the challenge where we were not able to help them out. And in this period, we approached the government.
In past 2 years, regarding this medical tourism treatment of the patient in our stem cell or our rehabilitation patient has been totally impacted by this COVID. We have crossed more than 100 crores of vaccination in India. And I urge Government of India to ease the international flights for the patients to come here for the treatment.
The medical tourism industry in India is poised to become the next success story after software IT industry.
Because of this pandemic, we have a very less inflow of the patients. We request our government to ease of the visas, okay, and to ease of the immigration process. Earlier, we used to get patients directly from Kuwait, okay, and the other countries. But due to this connectivity issues, the patients are not coming directly to the Bangalore. Because of this, we are losing some business. Like, you know, it hits our Bangalore economy as well.
I mean, though we have impacted with the COVID virus, I'm sure India is going to come out with the flying colors. Because the world has witnessed and they've seen that we have manufactured our own vaccine, I am sure medical tourism is going to come up in a very big way in future. In fact, it will take 2-3 years, but we are going to come out as one of the favorite medical tourism destinations again.
In the last 2 years, this is medical tourism has had a huge setback in terms of revenue, in terms of employment. There were a lot of families which were dependent, and there were a lot of individuals who were dependent on medical tourism. It was a huge source of employment, which has definitely got affected in the last 2 years. We do need to understand it's not only about the employment and not only about the people working in this industry, but it is also the patients who are getting affected in this. There are a few conditions which needs to be treated in time, and they would have had to avail the quality healthcare, which is not happening because of the pandemic situations, the travel restrictions, the flight restrictions.
Actually, medical tourism industry is estimated to reach a market worth $32 billion in 2017 in cosmetic surgery, dentistry, cardiovascular surgeries, orthopedic surgeries, onco surgeries, reproduction, weight loss, scans, tests, health screening, and second opinions.
When I am talking about the medical services in the international market, the badly hit is not us, but patient. Patient is having a limitation because of the deterioration due to the health problem. So they have to get the service, medical services, as quickly as possible. But due to this pandemic, they are the one who is suffering from us, from the this pandemic. We are capable to cater our service to them, but due to this pandemic, they are impacted a lot. The only methodology for the patient to get treated is that we will utilize the IT technology to the maximum. So we will come to know the minute level of the patient condition, whether the patient is compared to the 10 days back, 1 month back, 6 months back, the patient is getting better or getting worse. So we will come to understand whether the patient is in the immediate requirement for the treatment. There is certain level of the bubble flight, so that a patient is given an opportunity to fly to the destination. But in order to do that, we have to provide the best information to the country also, that we are supporting this patient. And then we will explain to the patient, to the government, that this patient is really in need. That's the way forward and how we have to survive in this pandemic. Thank you.
Pandemic is going to live with us, and we'll have to live with it. COVID is not something which would disappear very soon. But fortunately, science and the medical community has learned a lot enough to keep all the patients safe and all the health workers very safe from cross-infecting each other. So that's one aspect. And secondly, many lives are lost for delay of the treatment or denied treatment in the fear of contracting COVID.
This pandemic has hit us really bad. So when we were ready to take our patients between our first and the second wave, what used to happen is that the other countries were having their second wave. So what was happening is that it's totally disconnected and fragmented situation out there. Happen in the future is that the vaccination will be a new visa in the future. Yes.
During the pandemic, almost all international flights were cancelled, although there has been a slow recovery in air flight demand since coronavirus restrictions were gradually lifted. Demand still remains abysmally low.
Pre-pandemic, we used to get patients from many regions like Asia Pacific, then the Middle East, mostly Kuwait, Oman, Yemen, Saudi Arabia, Africa, and from United States, as well as many European countries.
To conclude it, the medical tourism is an outsourcing medical services, primarily expensive surgery to low-cost countries. It offers financial value for growing burden of the cost in matured market like USA. It also provides an alternative for millions of uninsured people to receive affordable and accessible medical services from different part of the country.
So because of COVID, there's a delay in treatment, which is impacting lots of people outside India who want to come to India for treatment. So somehow over a period of time, I feel that there would be a solution coming for COVID treatment, which I think definitely would lead to many people normalizing lives and coming to each one of the places for seeking for the actual problems in life.
We are a medical tourism hub, and we have got a very good climate over here. A lot of patients are pending. They want to come to India for the treatment, but due to this laws, lockdown and everything, they are not able to come. And patients are requesting for the visa and all. We are trying to get them the visa, but again, as per the global agreement, only the patients who has got a severe illness only they can travel. And now the patient with the moderate illness or they have got some other illness are getting into the severe and they are coming here in India, and most of the time it's too late. Then the medical expenses, everything is increasing, what treatment plan, treatment cost, what we are given varies. So it is very difficult. Now it is a high time, we are losing so many lives. So it is a high time now India opens up and we can treat those patients who are waiting for in those countries to come down in India and to take the treatment. Thank you.
Soon after the strike of COVID-19, India managed to manufacture its vaccination to defeat the pandemic instead of importing it from other countries. This shows the advancement in technologies and genetic sciences that India has achieved so far.
Of Sacra World Hospital in Ghana. Yes, before the COVID-19 pandemic, we used to have a lot of patients from Ghana and other neighboring countries too. India, Bangalore, Sacra.
Pre-pandemic, we have had a strength of approximately 20 to 30 employees, wherein most of the companies, they did layoffs, but we are fortunate that we are managing with the same staff strength. We are hoping for a better future so that we can serve people and give more and more employments. Thank you.
As we say, hope sustains life. India is steadily going back to square one. Restrictions are eased and we are looking forward to treat patients from the countries where there is no treatment, say kidney transplants, liver transplants and all cardiovascular diseases.
Were usually doing the maximum business of exports. We are dealing in handicraft items and hand-knotted carpets. Due to the COVID, due to the international flights being suspended, no international passenger is coming to India, our business got totally suffered. Now we request the government to please ease the international flights so that our business can also.
Our businesses completely depends on the foreigners, mostly from America, England, Europe, as well as Middle East, like Saudi Arabia, Dubai, and all that. So since this pandemic happened, so everything has been collapsing. Now it's almost 2 years.
The growth of global medical tourism in the last decade has influenced overall growth of healthcare sector. Due to the multidimensional impact of the pandemic COVID-19 in the form of a global healthcare crisis, falling global economy, restricted international travel, the medical tourism industry is undergoing a substantial decline. Though it's not possible to estimate the extent of the economic impact of COVID-19 outbreak because the course and duration of the outbreak are still unknown and both cannot be predicted. However, economic deterioration is much more significant than the SARS outbreak, even in its current state. But hopefully, someday soon, things will open up, get back to normal. People around the world will be free again. Till then, stay safe.